Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala rasulullah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala. This is a video in response to our brother Mohammed Hijab, wafaqahu Allah, concerning the accusations that he made against our brothers in Maktab al-Salafiyyah. May Allah preserve them, our teachers, the likes of Sheikh Abu Khadija and Abu Iyad. May Allah preserve them both. And Allah, the Messenger of Allah said, "Unsu akhaka zaliman aw madhluma." The Messenger said, "Aid your brother. Either he's been oppressed or he is the oppressor." So the Sahaba said, "Okay, if he's been oppressed, we know how. What about if he's the oppressor?" Then he said, alayhi salatu wasalam, by stopping him from his oppression. Na'am. So likewise, we have to speak. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you speak, speak with justice. Na'am, with justice. So here, again, my brothers and sisters, I want to show you something that many of you are not aware of. When our brothers, Muhammad Hijab, our brothers in Markaz al-Sunnah, Hafidhahum Allah Ta'ala, and our teacher Abu Khadija, Abu Iyad refuted the mistakes and the errors of Muhammad, errors of Muhammad Hijab, instead of taking it back, even I advised him privately, you know, because I had a love for the brother, na'am? Na'am, even when he made mistake against Muawiyah, he knows, I advised him privately. Yeah, so I advised him, and also I have another one, voice note, that you can see clearly how I spoke to Muhammad Hijab nicely. Tell me, your brother, very aziz to me and everything.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Muhammad, how are you, akhi? How's everything? Akhi Muhammad, I'm sending you this PDF of Abu Iyad. Because, you know, just nasiha, akhi. You know, it's nasiha. And you know that me and you, we had like very good relation, alhamdulillah. You know, but the way you're moving, akhi, Allah al-musta'an, Muhammad, like starts everything. Because remember, we have to remember, akhi, may Allah bless you, that how we started. Start by Abu Safiya, wafaqahu Allah. He went and he spoke against so-called madakhila and al-jamiya. Na'am. And me, myself, may Allah bless you, Muhammad, akhi, I sent you Sheikh Fawzan, what he said about people that use this term of Al-Jamiyah, they are Hizbis. So when Abu Iyad wrote an article about him and him claiming that he's been dealing with this for 20 years and all of that from a bab, because whenever I started it, na'am, I mean Abu Iyad started with Abu Safiyyah, none of that. He started that Al-Jamiyah, Al-Khawarij, Murji'ah, all of these names, na'am, Muhammad. So, akhi, when Abu Iyad refused him, like as a nasiha, look, you seem clearly that you have no clue what you're saying. So, you know, take nasiha. Na'am, because refutation sometimes is nasiha, that's what it means. It means nasiha. Na'am, barakallahu feekum. So, Muhammad, akhi, what happened is when the brothers Markaz Sunnah made a video about you, when you said, let's cooperate, bring in everyone, I don't care. When the brothers made a video, you're on one side and the scholar is completely on the other side. And Abu Khadija summarizing that, instead of you being nice and sincere, saying, oh, it's a clear cut, I made a mistake. For the sake of argument, it's not a mistake. There's a misunderstanding. Let me clarify it. Or let me make it clear that I'm not upon this way. I'm upon this and that. Na'am. But what you did, you start attacking our Ustad Abu Khadija personally. Na'am. And this Muhammad, akhi, wallahi, I was surprised, akhi, when I was listening to your video. You went very low, Muhammad. I didn't expect that from you. And I will tell you, akhi, you're one of the people that very aziz al-qalb. Na'am, I will tell you that, Muhammad. Likewise now, Abu Iyad, when you start refuting brother Talab, and he's advising you, and clearly you misrepresented his argument, akhi. So read this, akhi, with qalb mufatih, Muhammad, may Allah bless you, akhi. And take back what is clear, mistake, take it back. May Allah bless you, akhi.
So I said, akhi, look, if you want to reply, reply with ilm. But because he cannot reply with ilm, and he doesn't have enough knowledge, I noticed that. So where did he start? He started a mission. He mentioned it by himself, he admitted it. He starts a mission against our brothers and our teachers. So that's the first thing. And also, my brothers and sisters, refutation is a mercy for the one who has been refuted if he's sincerely giving da'wah. Na'am. For example, one of the Salaf, he was refuting someone. So the student said to him, why are you backbiting so and so? He said, how dare you? I'm more merciful to him than his own parents because I'm trying to stop the people from following his misguidance. Okay, that's the first one. The second thing I just want to show, and may Allah guide our brother Mohammed Hijab and give him a tawfiq, because he's a Muslim brother without any doubt. We don't call him kafir, and we still love hidayah for him, guidance, and we still love for him to come back to the truth. Na'am. And to correct his mistakes, clear-cut mistakes. Na'am. So first one, I want to show the double standard of Mohammed Hijab. And this video, this is not my way, but I'm just doing it for the sake of argument, meaning I'm going to show you how easily we can play his game. But our first, let us see his double standard, the hypocrisy that he fell into. May Allah give him a tawfiq for guide to and hidayah and all of us. First one, he went to Reading, okay? So when he went to Reading, he spoke to people about an issue that he tried to accuse Spabs of. Na'am. There's a brothers in Salafi brothers in Reading. Na'am. So there was an issue between them and other brothers about taking the money and so on from the prevent money. So Mohammed Hijab, he stopped becoming a da'i. He became now Detective Colombo. Okay? He became Detective Colombo. He became journalist. He became dispatches. If you remember dispatches, Channel 4. Na'am. So he went to Reading. He spoke to one guy, okay? So he spoke to him about, yeah, they take money and they are with Spabs and everything. So anyone with Spabs has to be responsible for it, okay? So now guess what? So I said to Mohammed Hijab, I WhatsApped him again, look, my brothers and sisters, to show you out there, I'm not the first person to start this fitna. I don't go out there and speak openly on the cameras. Privately, again, I said, Akhi, look, the brothers out there, they sent me a letter from the council, and the council, they were happy how the money was spent, okay? So I sent it to him. So I said to him, Mohammed, if you went to Reading because you want to defend the council are happy how the money been spent. If you went to Reading to defend the Muslims there, then the money that was not taken from the Muslims, it was not from the da'wah money. It was given to them by the prevent money, and prevent money, they give it to you to have the youth, Muslims or the non-Muslims, from do like activities for them to stay away from the road or from extremism, okay? So, you know, he said, give me receipts. I said, brother, hold on, what about you? Why you don't show people receipt of £250,000 that's been raised for Salam? But anyway, I will show you now, my brothers and sisters, the letter that was given to those brothers from the council, and they said the money, they were happy how the money was spent. That's the first one. Secondly, now Mohammed Hijab, it seems like he has a problem for people taking prevent money. Okay? So therefore, anyone that's taking prevent money, we have to do investigation on him. Okay? We have to check him. Guess what? Subhanallah. How Allah quickly exposed this person. Mohammed Hijab, afterward, as he mentioned, he was on a mission, tried to tarnish the name of our brothers. May Allah bless them and preserve them and reward them for their good deeds. Spabs, he's bringing anyone and get Spabs, anyone, even if himself differ with him. So he brought his brother, Abdul Haq Baker, he brought him. Guess what? Abdul Haq Baker, even this takfiri guy online, he said something funny. He said Abdul Haq Baker is a prevent money before prevent came to existence. He himself is a prevent. Na'am? But he said other things which I don't agree with him, is battle, to call the person kafir, I don't agree with that at all. But Mohammed Hijab, my brother, may Allah bless you and give you tawfiq. You seem like you became Detective Colombo. But you had another person with you and you promote him in your channel. He's been taken, the prevent money has been given him £300,000 yearly. And when they stopped it, he was crying. And he was complaining, not crying literally, but that's what they say according to the articles and the newspaper. He seems, he was complaining, okay? So my brother Mohammed, how come you have not that investigation on him? Do you know why, my brothers and sisters? Because he's not Spabs. Also, the second conditions for Muhammad to accept your action, you have to be against Spabs, and you have to be free from Spabs. Not just against them, you have to be free, you have to be not with them, and you have to refute them in order for Muhammad to welcome you and to promote you to the whole world. That's the first one. So Abdul Baker, why you know investigation on him? £300,000 yearly. Where's the money going, bro? I mean, it's not my problem, but I'm just saying it for the sake of argument. Mohammed, big job now for you, Detective Colombo. Big job, £300,000. Not £16,000, £300,000, brother. Big job this one, and it will give you more time to do investigation, you know? But it's not spabs, do whatever you like to do. Now, we'll show you the articles from the newspaper, which Mohammed Hijab tried to use against our brothers, same thing, but I'm sure the double standard, which this brother Abdul Baker, they're saying about him, that he was taking money from prevents. Thirdly, now, why he brought Abdul Baker? Abdul Baker, he never brought him to speak up prevent money, because he himself took prevent money. Now, he's trying to say the brothers are womanizers. They get married and divorce, they get married and divorce, okay? But again, look how Allah exposed you, my brother Muhammad, may Allah give you tawfiq. Muhammad Hijab, then he wanted to do an interview with someone called Abu Usama al-Dhahabi. And then he went with someone from Canada. So this person from Canada, he gave Muhammad a website. Muhammad Hijab promoted that website in his channel. Guess what, my brothers and sisters, may Allah bless you all. And may Allah give us husnul khatima. And may Allah give us tawbah before we die, including our brother Muhammad, we make dua for him without any doubt. The same website, sisters, I don't know this website. Even Muhammad Hijab, he said, I don't know the website, but it's specialized. How do you know it's specialized if you don't know the website? But guess, ikhwa, and he never knew. The same website, there is over 20 accusations, and guess Abu Usama al-Dhahabi to be womanizer, to get married and divorce and to the other things. So my brother Muhammad, what happened? It seems like you care about the Salafi sisters. So what happened? No, you know why? Because Abu Usama is not spabs. And he has not refuted Muhammad Hijab correct refutation. Not Tamir. No, yeah, he has mistakes, like everyone has mistakes. No, he's still out. And this person, he's known for it. Na'am is no one known, well established for it. Okay? And even so-called shuyukh that he followed. Na'am. Anyway, so the point here is, even the person from Canada that he promoted, ikhwa, if you go to his Instagram, this person, he promotes sins openly. May Allah save his daughter, may Allah guide him and save his daughter. He's put in a video his daughter dancing for music. When he was confronted for it, he said, my family passed away, and excuses some. And himself doing other things, crazy things on Instagram. Do you know why? Muhammad Hijab, remember, in order for Muhammad Hijab to accept your good deed, according to him, two conditions. First one, you be angus spabs, and you should not refute him. And you should refute spabs as well. Three, maybe. Na'am. Look, wal'iyadu billah. Ana taqwa Allah. Where is the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you're doing? You da'wah for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the clear show us, Muhammad Hijab is not doing it for Allah. He's doing it to save himself. Because this, what he was doing, clearly go angus Quran. And I will finish this. Also, I want to mention, there is a video. While you're debating, there is a sister with, I don't know, but I'm showing the double standard, okay? The sister with niqab, she's telling your friend, Na'am Ali needs da'wah. Yeah, you know what you did, you know what you did.
How much?
Yeah, you are.
Okay. So you have a personal problem. What have I done?
Personal problem.
What have I done?
Listen, you know what you've done. So don't even.
What have I done?
You know what you've done.
What have I done? What have I done? There you go.
You don't know what you've done. Listen, don't make. I'm causing a scene.
What have you done?
I'm causing a scene. You're the liar.
Okay, what have I done?
Listen, you know what you've done. I don't need to explain.
Sister, this shouldn't be going. Why are you recording this,
bro?
what? I'm not here to expose anyone. That's your job. You're the one who's out. Expose so and so.
What have I done? Can you tell me what have I done?
Do you know what you've done?
What have I done?
Just move away from me, man. Why do you keep following me?
Sister, you're here. Nobody's following
me. Nobody's
following
me.
Sister, we've got psychological problems.
And I need to come listen to this guy.
Sister, go.
Go. What do you mean, go? I was in my house.
I'm here.
You're the one who came out. Come over to me.
Sister, go.
You always do that. Why do you keep following me? Why do you keep following me?
Sister, I'm married. Why would I need to
follow you? You're married.
Yes. Why would I need to follow you?
You mind yourself. Why would I need to follow you? You're married.
Bye-bye, sister. Assalamu alaikum.
You don't tell me. Assalamu alaikum.
So why don't you care about sisters? How come you haven't investigated that? Also, there is a sister on Twitter, she said to Ali Dawah, which she put something, so hold a minute, the same thing you're accusing spouts of, you fell into it as well. Your friend did something and the sister came to him and he turned away because he was his friend. Even a brother from them came to me and said, there's many things about them as well. I said, Akhi, look, this accusation, the brother can accuse a sister as well. And the sister, this, I don't deal with it. But my brothers, forgive me for this video. But this clarification to show Muhammad is not a person you should take him serious. And it shows you that he's not trustworthy in his da'wah. He's not truthful in his da'wah. For saving himself, he will do anything to save himself. Even he will fall into clear-cut contradiction. Okay, so I will finish with this verse from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Mohammed Hijab was going around spreading a fahisha and evil deeds among the Muslims for the sake of tarnishing their names, even though there is no clear proof. Because if I accuse you to be adulterer, it's not you have to prove yourself, you're innocent. I have to bring proofs. And what is the proof according to the Quran? Four witnesses. They saw the same thing. Otherwise, you'll be written down, kadab fasiq. A liar, sinner, and you should get lashes. And if you're a Saudi, you get lashes. Now, for according to the book of Allah, according to Allah, you're a liar and a sinner. So let us finish with this beautiful speech to show my brothers and sisters, our brothers in Maktab al-Salafiyyah, they give da'wah according to Quran Sunnah. Mohammed Hijab, compare this. Quran Sunnah, when they refute people of falsehood, they didn't talk about their woman. And they got married to two, they got divorced to three, four, na'am. Except Abu Lahab's wife. Because why? She was waging war against the Messenger of Allah. Not because she was married to another man and she done this, she done that. No. And so Allah refuting the shirk and calling it tawheed and sunnah. Na'am. And the Messenger of Allah. Quran and sunnah. Na'am. The kuffar's way, Prophet, he had many wives. Na'am. Same thing Muhammad Hijab doing. They have wives. They got married, divorced. Na'am. The Munafiqeen, Prophet's wife, she's adulterer. About Aisha and Arda. So compare. Who's following the Quran Sunnah and who's following the way in this bab, the way of the Munafiqeen and the Kuffar. Wal'iyadu billah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions Surah An-Nur. Inna alladhina yuhibbuna an tashi'a al-fahishatu fi alladhina amanu lahum adhabun alimun fi dunya wal akhirah. Wallahu ya'lamu antum la ta'lamun. The meaning of the verse, my brothers and sisters, and I will advise everyone to read this verse and reflect upon it. Everyone, those who listen to Muhammad Hijab or don't listen to Muhammad Hijab, read it and you will come to know what Muhammad Hijab, his mission that he claimed, it was a mission of falsehood. Based upon a falsehood, go went against the Quran. Alhamdulillah, Allah exposed him. Now, verily those who like that the crime of illegal sexual intercourse should be propagated among those who believe that they will have a painful torment in this world and in the hereafter. And Allah knows, and you know not. Imam Abdul Rahman al-Sa'di, may Allah have mercy upon him. As everyone knows, we're not people of opinion. I'm not going to give you my opinion about the book of Allah or the hadith. No, alhamdulillah, we are people of al-Athar wal-Hadith. Alhamdulillah. So Abdul Rahman al-Sa'di, one of the a'immatul deen, may Allah have mercy upon him, said here, about those who likes the evil actions to spread amongst the Muslims, they will have he mentioned the evil actions, the actions that will hurt the believers' hearts. Na'am, they hurt their feelings. Na'am, because he wants the evil to spread amongst the believers, especially, he said, in the a'rad, their honor, accusing them of fornication, adultery, stealing, and other things. Na'am, so he says here, He said, so this is evil things to do. I'm just summarizing the translation. He said, what about the one, he said, just speaking about it. He said, what about the one spreading it and narrating it? You don't do that. If someone accuses a brother of something, no, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you have proof, go to the court, mahkamah al-shar'iyyah. Don't lie. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't spread the accusation against the believers. So this is the book of Allah. And alhamdulillah, this is tafsir Shaykh Abdul Rahman al-Sa'di. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us sincerity. And I want to challenge Mohammed Hijab and Ali Dawah. You accuse spabs, they took £1 million from private money. Where is the proof for that? Naam, where is the proof? Again, and remember, your friend and both of you have not apologized openly. The lie you made, Allah angers us, concerning that we were there and we saw Ahmed getting beat up. So my brothers, as I mentioned, forgive us for this, but it had to be done. And I know our da'wah is to quote Quran Sunnah, teach the people and the Muslims Islam, the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but from our deen to defend ourselves and to defend our teachers. So this is one video, not all the time we do that, alhamdulillah, but we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us sincerity and to unite our hearts upon the truth. Subhanakallah bihamdik, ashadu an la ilaha illa ant, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.